And I'll have it. You won't be able to stop me. No. No.
You don't work every
stop,
day.
Stop. Shut up. I actually am working right now.
You mean after this interview?
No, I mean right now. I'm doing what we call in the business vibing.
Oh.
It's a little inside. Let me show you what I mean. What do you see me doing?
You're just sitting there.
You're doing that funny thing with your mouth.
And my mouth, it's to the untrained eye. What I'm actually doing is vibing, or, you know, putting out those waves of good lookingness, sort of promoting, advertising myself subliminally.
You getting this?
Okay, let me ask you this question. Are you finding yourselves inexplicably wanting to have a little bit of open mouth action with me?
No.
No.
I think you are.
No. Why?
Because I'm vibing on a major, major, major scale right now. So much so that heterosexual men want to have a little bit of action with this area right here.
I'm not sure we're all on the same page.
Okay.
Well, let's all turn to chapter one, shall I? Please pick up your books, children, and turn to chapter one. Okay, my name is Alessandro Di Pietro, which translates in Italian to Alessandro from stone. I think it's clear that from birth I radiated sex. I'm kind of like this symbol this town needs. Not unlike Batman. Not unlike Batman. You should probably be writing this down. Wait, do you feel that? Do you feel that? Do you that?
Yeah. You should get that.
No, this is my favorite part. And the last of the song.
Is that vibing?
This is dancing. Bella, take some notes.
We're a totally independent operation, so we have to sort of exploit any kind of opening we have to talk about the film, to market the film, to sell the film. And one of the big set pieces in the movie is our horrible, awful 25-year-old Cadillac Eldorado, piss yellow, that the guys all drive down to senior week to party and chase girls. So if you want to get a shot at this, is the horrible automobile here. And one thing you'll notice is that the car appears to be in fine working condition, because a little 409 and paper towels, you know, you can make it viewable, which is what we had to do. But it only ran for the first 3 weeks of the production. The last 2 weeks of the production, the car literally sat in a movie theater parking lot in Ocean City, dead. Up to that point, we would have to time the takes that the actors did in 3-minute intervals, because the car would run for only 3 minutes at a time.